Just pray in tongues. Just pray in tongues for a few minutes. Just let go. Just let the release the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Rabashika, 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 rabashika. Yes, brothers and sisters, take your position. Just pray in tongues for a while so that our Holy Spirit, invite our Holy Spirit to be right now in our midst. Just give thanks to Him. Yes, in your ways. Give thanks to our Lord. Yes, just give thanks to Him. Hallelujah. Rabashika, 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 rabababababa. Hurabaka, rabaria, rabashikiria, rabababababa, rabashanda, rabarabarabaria, rabababa. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, God. We thank you for your wonderful presence right now. Lord, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, we thank you for Holy Spirit. Yes. Giving Holy Spirit to us. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Rabashika, ria, rabashika. Yes, just worship. Just praise Him. Just give thanks to our Lord. Yes, invite the Holy Spirit to be with us in this midst right now. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for your wonderful presence in this place of God. Father, we thank you. But right now, we can feel you. That your presence is here. Your presence is real in this place. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory to your name, O Father God. Glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this wonderful morning, O Father God. We give you thanks, O God, for all the blessing you have given us, for the blessing you poured, you showered on us, oh Father God. Lord, we thank you. Lord, thank you, Lord, that you woke us up this morning, God. That is the greatest gift in our lives, oh Father God. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we commit our congregation, Lord, the brothers and sisters right now into your mighty hands, oh Father. Remove, oh Father God. Forgive, oh Father God, whatever not right with us, oh Father God. Yes, Lord, cleanse us, oh Father. Cleanse our heart. Yes, we want to come to you with clean heart, oh Father. This morning, we want to worship you. Yes, whatever pain, oh Father God, remove it. Whatever hurts, oh Father God, remove in the name of Jesus. All the sicknesses is gone in the blood of Jesus. By your stripes we are healed. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory to you, God. Father, once again, we lift up our musicians, Lord, our music ministry into your mighty hands of you, Lord. We lift up, we praise, we thank you for our worship leader this morning, oh Father God. Father, let your anointing flow. Yes, Lord. When she sing, Lord, the Spirit of God with her. May the Spirit of God lead and guide and bring to the higher level, oh Father. We also pray for all the guitarists, the pianoists, the musicians, everything, oh Father, everyone, oh Father God, into your hands of you. Father, when they play, it's you, Lord. It's you, Lord, playing. Not we, Lord, as a human, but Holy Spirit, you going to play the music for us, oh God. Thank you. Thank you, all the glory and honor we give you, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we also pray for our speaker this morning, oh Father. He's driving to Strabba Life Assembly, Lord. We pray for his safe journey. Yes, oh Father God, when he speaks, Lord, the word is from you. Let the word speak to us. All the glory back to you, God. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, flow this place and take your place right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rabashika, rabababara.
Praise the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Give a mighty clap to Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, for this morning. Amen. Welcome, everybody. Those of us online, those of us here, welcome. Amen. Hallelujah. This morning, we want to bless the Lord. Amen. So, are you ready to bless the Lord? Oh, are you ready? Let me hear your shout. Hallelujah. Let's clap our hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you forever, Lord. I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you forever, Lord.
Can we sing together?
I love you.
Bless the name of the Lord.
I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you.
How many of you love the Lord? Come on.
I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you forever, Lord.
We worship. Sing to the Lord. Together, 1, 2, come on.
I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you forever, Lord.
We worship
forever.
Glory.
Glory to God.
praise and give all the glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Come on, clap your hands and give the Lord a worship. Hallelujah. Woo! Everybody clap your hands and give God a praise this morning. Hallelujah. I'm trading my sorrows. I'm trading my pain, yeah. I lay them down for the joy of the Lord. Let's sing together. Sickness. I'm trading my pain. Yeah. I lay them down for the joy of the Lord. Everybody, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. Do you believe that? Yes, yes, Lord. Come on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. I'm pressed by no curse, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I'm blessed beyond the curse, for his promise would endure, for his joy gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, his joy comes in the morning. I'm trading my sorrow. I'm trading my pain. I lay them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness. I'm trading my sickness. Trading my pain.
I'm trading my pain.
I laid them down.
For
the joy of the Lord is my strength. Hallelujah. Say yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Can I hear your tongue? Come on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. Everybody, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. His promise are yes and amen. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen.
Now let's move our hands like this. Let's go. La 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 la. Say yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. How many of you believe that God's promises are yes and amen? Are you here? I wanted to declare yes, Lord, again. But the Bible said his promises are yes and amen. Hallelujah. Come on, let's do it one more time. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen.
Come on, declare.
Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. Say yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Amen. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. Put your hands together and give Lord praise in this room. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes and amen. Can you lift your hands wherever you are? Lift your hands to the Lord. Lift your hands. Thank you, Jesus. Would you lift your voice and begin to worship Him in your own language, wherever you are? Jesus. Le kolobaba shede de bahata yalaba. I kalababa shede le koria balaba shede kiyata pali kiyasaba. Come on. All the worshipers, lift your voice. Let's worship. La kombi de kasata le korabase. In lolobo se bele hiya la kasa bele komba de yasa. Thank you, Lord. La gobo se bele biya kaba zande de baha. We bow before you, Lord, this morning. We lift up your name, O God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We worship you. We worship you. Bow down and worship Him. Bow down and worship Him. Worship Him. Oh, worship Him. Bow down and worship Him. Bow down and worship Him. Worship Him. Oh, worship Him. Jesus, Jesus the King of Kings. Jesus the King of Kings. Worship Him. Worship Him. Thank you, Lord. Oh, worship Him. Saint Jesus, Jesus the King of Kings. Jesus the King of Kings. Worship Him. Oh, worship Him. He says that, consume me, fire, sweet perfume, His awesome presence, fill this place, for this is holy grounds. So come and bow down.
You want to sing one more time? Consuming.
Consume me, fire, sweet perfume, His awesome
presence,
fill this place, for this is holy ground. So come, so
lift your hands and worship the Lord.
Bow down and worship Him. Worship Him.
everybody declare.
Bow down and worship me. Oh, worship him.
Let's declare.
Jesus, Jesus the King of Kings. Jesus, Jesus the King of Kings. Worship Him. Oh, worship Him.
Consume Him.
Consume me, fire, sweet perfume. His awesome presence fill this place. For this is holy grounds.
Yes, Lord.
So come and bow.
Consume it. Our hands as we worship the Lord. Room, lift your hands to the Lord.
To worship you, I leave.
Yes, Lord.
To worship you, I leave to worship you. To worship you, I leave. To worship you, I leave.
How many of you believe that? Can you lift your hands and worship the Lord? If you believe, then lift your hands to the Lord.
To worship you, I live.
Yes, Lord.
To worship you, I live to worship you.
Oh. This morning, let's sing. Oh, 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 oh. With a louder voice, the Lord, hallelujah. Oh, 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 oh. Thank you, Lord. Oh, 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 oh. With me, we bow down,
we bow down,
yes, Lord,
and worship Yahweh. We bow
and worship, Lord,
and worship Yahweh.
Call the name of the Lord, Yahweh, It's all about Him. Lift your voice and sing to the Lord. Lift your voice. Yahweh. Believe that, can you lift your hands and wave to the Lord? We bow down, we bow down and worship Yahweh, 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 Yahweh. Your hands to the Lord. Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. Everybody, just close your eyes and just sing to the Lord. Just sing it. Yahweh, Yahweh, oh, hey, Yahweh, 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 Yahweh. Yeah, Yahweh, Yahweh, yeah. Just take 20 seconds and lift your voice and bless the name of the Lord. Rekoraba de ko sande de karaba da ba da ba le kala da ba da ba mo sa le kala da mo sa da ba le hatoni akaba. Come on, lift your voice, lift your voice. Take this step, 20 seconds, and bless the name of the Lord. Rekobo setele mabala, o sende debaha. Le kamba le kobo sende debaha. Let the heavens hear your voice this morning, somebody. Lift up your worship to the Lord this morning. Rekobo bo setele baha. Yes, 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 yes. Rekobo bo setele baha. Let the heavens hear your voice, setele baha. Rendo bo 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 sende haba, le kobo setele baha. Le kapapa le bo sete le kapaha, etele bo sete le papapa le kobo sete la. Yes Lord, 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 yes Lord. Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh.
We love you, Lord. We bless your name, Lord.
Yes Lord, Yahweh. Yahweh, would you clap your hands and give the Lord a shout in this room? Come on, somebody, come on. Give the Lord a worship with a clap offering. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. It's all about you this morning, oh God. We call you Yahweh, we call you El Shaddai, Elohim, Lord. We bow before your throne this morning, oh God. Have your way, oh God, this morning. In the name of Jesus, thank you for your presence, oh God. We bless your holy name, Father, in Jesus' name. Come on, clap your hands and give the Lord a shout. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah.
Praise the Father. Praise the Son. Praise the Holy Spirit. Praise the Godhead. Praise the three in one. Praise Yahweh. Praise the great I Am. Praise El Shaddai. Praise the everlasting God. Praise Abba Father. We praise you by all your name, Lord. We praise you by all your name. We praise you by all your name, Lord. We praise you by all your name. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. You are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they exist and were created. You are worthy to receive the scroll and to open its seal, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. Blessing and honor and glory and power be to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. You are Jehovah Rohi, the Lord our shepherd. You are Jehovah Shalom, the Lord our peace. You are Jehovah Shammah, the Lord that is with us in us. You are Jehovah Nishi, the Lord our banner. You are Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. You are Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer. You are Jehovah Shitkenu, the Lord our righteousness. Hebrews 13:15 says, therefore by him let us continually offer the sacrifice of praise to God, that is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to him, giving thanks to his name. Bible verse, and today's Bible verse taken from the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verses 20 to 25. My son, give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to all their flesh. I repeat that now. For they are life to those who find them and health to all their flesh. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. Put away from you a deceitful mouth and put perverse lips far from you. Let your eyes look straight ahead and your eyelids look right before you. Let's pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Yes. Ushers, please be ready. Ushers. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, Holy Spirit, you are Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. We thank you for providing for our daily needs and fulfilling our desires. All that we have belongs to you. We now give you what you have given us, Lord. Continue to give us a heart of giving. When we give, we are blessed. For all things come from you, and of your own you have given. Yes, and of your own you have given. Now I'm going to read from 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 to 11. Huh? But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. For let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity. For God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, always having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. As it is written, He has dispersed abroad, He has given to the poor. His righteousness endures forever. Now may he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food, supply and multiply the seed you have sown and increase the fruits of your righteousness. Hallelujah. You can now come forward and give your tithing.
Give thanks with a grateful heart.
Thank you for the tidings. You will be doubly blessed. The Lord will bless you doubly. The elders of Sramban Life Assembly, welcome Pastor Gurmeet Singh. Are there any newcomers today? Any newcomers? No. And also welcome all brothers and sisters who are here. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the beautiful worship. We bring before you the entire worship team, led by Brother Akise, the backup singers, the musicians, the LCD players. Yes, let our worship reach the heavens, and let there be rejoicing in heaven, and out of the rejoicing pour down exceedingly and abundantly your blessings and promises. Bless everyone, Lord. Bless everyone. You know, yesterday, when I went to bed about 10:30, suddenly I had some anxiety, some nervousness, fear, and I didn't know why. I was wondering what is happening. Then a thought came into my mind, pray. And then I said, okay, pray for what? Pray for the nation. So I'm going to pray for the nation today. Last night I prayed. Why we have to pray? Even it is 5 minutes a day, brothers and sisters, please go on your knee and pray for the nation. Very, very important. Yesterday, when I checked the WhatsApp and all that, somebody sent a message. Gathering in KL. Gathering of the opposition in KL. For the first time in Malaysian history, I don't know how many of you realize it, the opposition that has got 74 members of parliament, there is not one non-Malay there. Not one non-Malay in the opposition. We are not going to condemn or criticize, but we are telling the truth. Not one. So when they meet in parliament and they are trying to cause havoc, they have openly now said, we are going to bring down this unity government. Okay? So we are going to pray for that. Lord, you have said, pray for those in power because you put them there. So we pray for them. Our Father, Lord Jesus, Holy Spirit, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We pray for our King, the Deputy King, the Sultans, the Chief Ministers, the Governors, the Prime Minister, Deputy Prime Ministers, all Cabinet Ministers, all Deputy Ministers, all Parliamentary Secretaries, all the 222 Members of Parliament who are representing us in Parliament. They play a very, very important part. The Attorney General, the Speaker of Parliament, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, the Speaker of the Senate, the Deputy Speaker of the Senate, the Inspector General of Police, the Chief Justice, Associate Justices, the Supreme Court, all law enforcement officers, which includes the police force, the army, the navy, the air force, all government servants, yes, all those government servants and all those who are involved in the daily administration running of this country. We pray, Lord, that they will receive the wisdom of God, your wisdom, Lord, and to act in obedience to the wisdom of God, your wisdom, Lord, and for the power of God to flow in their lives. Yes, for the power of God to flow in their lives. Whatever they do, Lord, let them realize that whatever they do, let them do in the fear of you, O Lord, and live a life of righteousness, holiness, honesty, purity, integrity, godly sincerity, godliness, and in the fear of you, Lord, knowing that you're watching their every move, Lord, and every action of theirs, Lord. Yes. We also pray, Lord, just as you gave Solomon wisdom to rule, Lord, grant unto our leaders the wisdom to govern the affairs of this nation, Malaysia, in the name of Jesus. O Lord, give unto our nation, Malaysia, people like Joseph, who will understand your way of doing things in the name of Jesus. We pray that the light of you, Lord Jesus, shall shine in every nook and corner of this land, Malaysia, in the name of Jesus. We pray for godly leaders, Lord. We pray you will bless our nation, Malaysia, through godly leaders, in the name of Jesus. Thank you and amen. Now, before, I think they still got time. Any testimony? Any testimony? No testimony, yeah. No testimony is not good, because the Lord says, and they defeated Satan and his demonic forces by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Every service we must have testimony. Doesn't matter whether it's a small testimony, short testimony, long testimony, but we must give testimony. So since there is no testimony, can we all put our hands together and we invite Reverend Gurmeet Singh to come and give his word. Holy Spirit, speak through him. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God is a good God. Amen. So good to be in the house of Jesus. How many say amen to that? Praise the Lord. Good to see you all today. It is really good to see each one of you all. Every Sunday, whenever you go to the house of God, you find God's strength and God's wisdom. Amen. God's strength and God's wisdom. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Is it right, Mike? No. Another mic. Is it? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We need to keep praying for our nation. Just keep praying. Lord is doing a wonderful thing in Malaysia. Amen. And as brother just prayed for, just keep that in a matter of prayer. Don't forget, because your prayer is powerful. Your prayer is powerful. Hallelujah. In the midst of us today, even as we pray for our nation, but there are some that are seated here. You have a prayer need in yourself. Would you mind standing up to your feet if there's any prayer need in your hand? Would you mind standing up to your feet? Come on. I want to just stretch your hand before the Lord right now. Whoever there's a prayer need, you have a prayer need. You want God to bless you, touch you, bring a breakthrough to you. And wherever you are, just stand and stretch your hand. Open up your hand before the Lord. Say, Father, Lord, I have a prayer need. I surrender to you my life to your hand. Come on. I surrender to you, Lord, my life to your hand. Lord, my need is to have a blessing from you. Therefore, Lord Jesus, I lift up my hand. I lift up my head. Come on, lift up your head. I need a healing in my body. I need a breakthrough in my body. Lord, I need a divine touch of God in my family. I need a touch of God in my marriage. I need a breakthrough, Lord Jesus, in my life. Therefore, Lord, I lift up my hand before you. I pray for your divine breakthrough, divine grace, divine unction. I come against every roadblocks. I come against every roadblocks in my life, oh God. I arrest it in Jesus' name. I pray for open door. I pray for open door. I come against every roadblocks in my life. I arrest it in Jesus' name. I pray for open door. Lord, open the door. Lord, I pray for those who are struggling, oh God. Struggling, Lord Jesus. I pray that you will set them free. Set them free. Let the healing of God come upon them. Let the presence of God come upon them. In Jesus' name, I pray for those who are not able to hear. There's someone here. You have a problem with hearing. The Lord says, I'm going to touch your ears and you're able to hear well. Lord, I speak to the one who have a hearing problem. In the name of Jesus, I speak for supernatural healing power to come right now. Touch your God. Let your presence flow in this place, oh Father. Jesus is here. He's touching. He's blessing. Lord, heal, oh God. Touch your God. In the name of Jesus, I pray for supernatural breakthrough. Let there be healing come. Let there be grace come. Let there be mercy come. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, unction of the Holy Ghost, unction of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, just focus your eyes on the Lord. Amen. Just don't get so distracted. Just focus your eyes on the Lord. He is here to heal. He is here to touch. He is here to bless. In the name of Jesus. Supernatural grace, supernatural mercy, supernatural goodness, oh God. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Lord, thank you. Bless, release. Grace of God over each one of them. In the name of Jesus, pray in us. And all of you say, amen, amen. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Very quickly, I just want to show a short video before I preach. You know, many times people ask me, hey, Pastor Gurmeet, nobody know what you're doing, you know. You come, you preach, you go back. So I thought I would just share to you what I do on a daily basis, just to let you know the ministry that I'm involved in beside preaching and teaching and doing the work of God. I have another one more ministry that I'm very much involved, very passionate about, to help the needy and the poor. So this is a short video. It's been there for a while, but I thought it's a good time for me to show you all today, all right? So let's watch this for a while. My name is Gurmeet. I am a coordinator for this Grace Community Services. Me and my wife Selena, we have been here for close to 15 years. It is Grace Community Services. We do a feeding program to the poor, where we give them a hot meal every Sunday and throughout the week. We also have a clothing program where we give them free clothes, toiletry goods, clinic for the poor where we give them a simple medical assistance wherever we can. For the local and also refugees, asylum seekers. This is our clothing. We give it to all the street people, to the poor people. And these are some of the stocks we have, the shoes. We give them shoes, we take it down there. We also have a very large bathroom where they can come and have a shower and wash their clothes and keep themselves clean. Through this whole journey in this Grace Community Services, it has been a great experience for me and my dear wife Selena, seeing life transform and change. That's our motivation, to see life transform and change. Many of them come from a broken family. Many of them are depressed, mental illness, they are prostitutes. Many of them struggle with alcohol and drugs. Many have been abused by their loved ones, father, mother, sister, brothers. Some are sexually abused, some are mentally abused. Some are having nervous breakdown. Many of them have broken dream. And they come from many backgrounds, from every race, Chinese, Indian, Malay, Punjabi, name it, every race. They come with hurts and bondages and baggages in their heart. And we here in Grace Community Services, we go a little bit extra mile by taking time to talk to them and hear them out and feed them and clothe them and give them whatever assistance we can
even for me, I visit them in the hospital. I take them to the hospital and do their medical checkup to find out how they're doing. Sometimes even go with them for a work interview to see how they get the job. How I find people walk to me, and this one lady walked to us and she said, thank you for this packet of rice. You don't know what you're doing. You know, I have no hot meal. I have no meal for the past 2 days. You know, and this packet of rice have given me warmness in my heart. And that is great, isn't it? That's a great testimony. I also have people who come and live their life like a bum. There's a young man who actually basically lost everything in his life and totally devastated with his life. And he just don't want to live anymore. We sat up with him, talked to him, the volunteer talked to him, I talked to him, counseled him. And guess what? He, through the whole experience of feeding and helping him in wherever we can, he decided to give up his street life and went and work and start earning. And the best part is this, is today he's helping the street people himself, feeding them and walking with them and talking to them. And there are families, you know, who live in the street, you know, for years and never want to transform their life and just being what a street life is all about. And we go alongside with them, giving them hot meal, talk to them and speak to them, and they decided to make a change and got a government flat, a DBKR flat, and start to live in the flat and start earning wages. Where do we get our help from? From you guys, just like you. We get help from individuals, we get help, financial help we get from individuals, we get from company, we run a CSR program, college students. We even get help from the religious bodies. You know, we have the Buddhists, the Taoists, the Hindu, the mosque, even the church. You know, people come alongside with us to buy the food and pay for the meal and provide us dry goods. And so one of the greatest needs that we have right now is in our clinic for the poor. We are really needed of doctor. So now we're looking for a few more doctors to come alongside with us. So if you're a medical doctor, you're willing to spare some time to help us in a street program, you're most welcome. We're looking for nurse and volunteers who can cook. We're also looking for people who can come alongside with us in support group, helping the drug and the alcoholics, runaway children, runaway youth, broken youth. And we're looking for some people who can come and help us in grooming, you know, cutting hair. So we welcome you. Come and join us in Grace Community Services. Me and my wife and all the volunteers are looking forward to seeing you.
Amen. Come on, give God a clap offering, all right? This has been going on for the past 20 years. I've been very much involved in this. But this is just partial of what we are doing. There's many more things that we do that we can't put it up on video. But God is good to us. So if you want to come alongside to help us in any manner, by volunteering, by giving out some food, or by giving some dry goods or financial support will be very much needed, because a lot of them that come on our way suddenly knock the door of my office, say, Pastor, we need help to pay for school fee and tuition fee and house rental, electricity, sometimes cash. You know, you need to have ready cash, and I don't have a time. But if you are there, you feel led to help, please let us know. Come alongside. You can come through your church here. You can come on your own as an individual, as the Lord leads you. But let your pastor and your leaders know as you serve the Lord together to build the kingdom of God. Amen. So this little thing that you guys been doing, so my coming here every Sunday whenever I can has been a blessing too, huh? So that I'm able to sustain what God has put in my life. All right. So this is not a waste of time. They are life transform, life touch, life change. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. How many of you are excited to be in God's presence? Amen. I want to start this morning with this quote. When I read this quote, it hit me a little bit, you know. I want to read this quote, you know. So if God, listen, you got to read it properly, all right? Read it properly. If God loves his children, is to be measured by health, wealth, and comfort in this life, then God hated Apostle Paul. You understand what I mean? Because Apostle Paul had no good health. Apostle Paul has no wealth. Apostle Paul has no comfort in his life. He had thorn in his flesh. He had no money. He got to live on his own earning. All right, 10-man ministry. He has no comfort. Most of the life he was in prison. In fact, majority of the epistle written in prison. And he was chained in prison. And in that whole environment, he still rejoiced for God's glory over his life. So if you think having health, wealth, and comfort in your life is to measure your spiritual walk with the Lord, then God must have not loved Paul as much as you all. Because Paul went through worse than that. Shipwreck, bitten by a snake, flogged, you know. He was flogged with not just rotan. This is a flogging means when Roman Empire used to flog people, they have cat of nine tails. He went through the flogging. And being a Roman citizen, being a citizen of the land, he was still gone through that experience. Never fought back, just kept quiet. So when I read this, I say, God, we are so blessed. Hallelujah. We are so blessed. We have roof on our head, food on our table. You are sitting in an air-conditioned sanctuary. We are so blessed. Hallelujah. We have everything. Come on, lift up your hand for a moment. Say, God, thank you for blessing me. Thank you, Lord, for blessing me. Thank you for giving me good strength, education, life. Lord, I am so grateful and thankful for your provision in my life. There are many, God, don't even have those provision. Don't even have those breakthrough. Lord, we are so grateful that you have been kind to us. Help me not to forget that, oh God, and get myself disappointed, discouraged, disillusioned, dismayed. Help us to remember, Lord, that you are our giver and our blesser. Into your hand we commit Jesus' name, pray in us, and all of you say, amen. Amen. Remember this. It's a very powerful truth. John Piper brought it out, and I thought, wow, we are blessed. So therefore, today I want to speak to you about spiritual prosperity. All right, everybody like prosperity. Who don't like prosperity? Everyone like prosperity, right? Fat Loma, huh? Oh, likes it. Let's just enjoy prosperity. But there is also in the Bible, the Word of God, that we must learn about spiritual prosperity. I want to read to you from the life of Hezekiah. And I want to speak to you about his life. Sometimes we look at the heroes of the world. You know, I want to become like Bill Gates. I want to become like Tim Cook. I want to become like this, all the heroes of the world. But do you know there are heroes of the Bible that you actually can follow? And you can follow these heroes of the Bible and learn the truth about their life and live accordingly. The problem with today's church is we become a motivation club. Church become motivation. We don't bring the scripture. We don't bring the truth of God's heroes in the Bible. We bring all the other heroes in the world. They have no connection with us because the Word of God is only life that we have. Every hero in the scripture here meant to be for you to learn. So I want to speak to you about the life of Hezekiah. And if you've got a Bible, you can turn to that. Otherwise, let's look at the scripture here. 2 Chronicles chapter 31, verse 20 to 21. All right? It's a beautiful story about the life of Hezekiah. This is what Hezekiah did throughout Judah, doing what was good and right and faithful before the Lord his God. Doing what is good and right and faithful before the Lord our God. Listen, this is very powerful. I hope when you die one day, of course, don't talk about die. Eh? For Chinese, die means so, yeah. Che, don't talk. But death will come, am I right? Nah? You can never run away. We will face death one day. We will meet death. He will knock on our door and then that's it, over. You cannot say, wait. No, it's over. You know. So we will go to an expiry time. We will also get expired. So the day will come. We cannot run away from that. I'm shocked today. Many of them are dying. So someone is saying a quote. Please start using all your shirt and your dress and your shoe. Don't keep them in the cupboard anymore. Because life is so short. People are dying faster than using up their clothes. Death is anytime happening. I'm shocked. I'm reading news. This guy died. That guy died. These are the people I know of. A pastor just died, 50 over years old, died. I'm very puzzled. I see what's happening. And one of the very good actors I know just died, 60 years old. So when you start seeing 45, 50, what is life? That's what the Bible says. It is like a vapor. It's like a vapor. So I hope this will be on your tombstone. I hope this will be on your tombstone. This was your name, Hezekiah,
did throughout Seramban. Doing what is good and right and faithful before the Lord is God. You know, your tombstone will have something written on top of that. I hope this will be there on your tombstone. You know, in everything that he undertook in the service of God's temple, in obedience to the law and the command, he sought his God and worked wholeheartedly so he will prosper. So he will prosper. Sought after God. Sought after God. Hallelujah. Wow. Ezekiah prospered. If you read the scripture carefully, how did he prosper? How did Ezekiah prosper? Look at the scripture. I mean, if you want to understand the text of the word of God, you got to read it backward. How did Ezekiah prosper? You know, you got to read that again and again, one by one, to understand what the Lord is saying. So how did Ezekiah prosper? Thank you, Jesus. He prospered. Read carefully, yeah? He prospered because he worked wholeheartedly. He prospered because he sought his God. He prospered because he followed the commandment. He prospered because he was obedient to the law. He prospered because he served in the temple. He prospered because he was faithful. He prospered because he was good and he did what is right throughout his life. See how? That's how you read the scripture. So now what happened? The scripture become life. Don't just miss what the Lord is doing because the Lord wants to bring clarity to you. So what we learn here in Ezekiah chapter 32 verse 32, the Bible say what? He prospered because he make it as an act of devotion. Act of devotion. He had a spiritual prosperity because he took time to devote himself in the presence of God. He took time to devote himself in the presence of God. He didn't play around. He took time to be serious. In fact, Paul reminds us in the book of Romans, he said what? For everything that was written in the past, Ezekiah is a story of the past. For everything written in the past was written to teach us. Why God put the story of Ezekiah? So that we can learn from it. To teach us. So that through the endurance taught in the scripture, what is taught in the scripture? Not in a motivation book. What is taught in the scripture? What is taught in the word of God? He will able to encourage you, able to bring what? The word of God. What is taught in the past will able to encourage you and provide you might and you have hope. Let me tell you, brother, what is more important in life is hope. Today we have in the world, people are living hopelessly. I feed the poor, I work in the street. When I talk to them, they all have a hopeless language. People who are sick, who are dying of cancer, they have a hopeless language. I cannot make it. I'm gone. I'm going to die. Hopeless language. We are living in an environment where people have no hope. Everything they look around and see is hopeless. But let me remind you, this scripture is to remind us this story about the men in the book of Ezekiah, a story about Hezekiah, all the great leaders like Moses, Abraham, all these great leaders that you read in the Bible, Jeremiah, you know, you pick Joshua, all these, Obadiah, all these great people, you learn about how they live their life and never compromise their walk before God. So today, we're going to explore this journey. Are you ready? We're going to explore this journey together. And may God give you wisdom and grace to learn. I want to teach today because this is what I'm called to do. I love to teach. I love to encourage people with the word. I love to see people grow in the grace of God. And because the word of God is the only strength I have. Unless the word of God fail on us, we have nowhere else to go. So what we learn here? All right, same scripture. I highlight the yellow one. Let's look at the yellow one first. Same scripture, right? And everything that undertook in the service of God's temple. So, what is number one? In every work that he began in the service of the house of God. You got to understand this very clearly. Everything starts in the house of God. And some people come and tell me, I do this, I do that, I do this, I do that. I turn to them and say, which church you come from? Oh, I got no church. The Holy Spirit is my church. Hello? Where you learn this from, huh? Who taught you? The Holy Spirit is not your church. The word church is ecclesia. He needs people. He needs assembly of people. This building is not a church. If you are not here today, and I'm only alone here, then I'm no more church. I'm speaking to what? Nothingness. But because there are two or three gathered here, the Lord says His presence is here, and that becomes the church. Church is not the structure of the building. You can meet in a home. If there's two or three, that's become a church. That's why the Bible says two or three agree on earth. It's done in heaven. Have you wondered why two or three, not 2,000, 3,000? Why there was no 100, 200 people? Sometimes we wonder, prayer meeting, why our prayer meeting not big? Why so small? And we get very disappointed, discouraged. Huh? I realize it's okay lah, to have a small prayer meeting. At least we got agreement. Because the power of agreement is more important than the power of the crowd. You can have the crowd, but there is no agreement. When there is no agreement, no use. That's the reason agreement is very powerful. So here, Hezekiah learned one of the very important truths about his life is to serve God in the house of God. Serve the Lord. Give his life to the Lord. Give his time to the Lord. Give his mind and heart to the Lord. He never allowed anything to take advantage of because he felt it is important to be in the house of God because everything starts there. In fact, Paul advised Timothy. This is what Paul told to Timothy. You will know how people ought to conduct themselves in a God's household. How do you supposed to live your life in a house of God, which is the church, the living God, the pillar of the foundation of truth? What did Paul is saying to us about the house of God? What is God saying to us about us as a church? We are the church of a living, not a dead God. We have a living God. As you and I come together, we declare the name of the living God. How many of you say amen to that? A living God. And what we are the pillar, you know, pillar and the foundation. This is very important when you're building any structure. You need to have a good foundation. You need to have a good pillars. Am I right? And there is no foundation, there is no pillar, nothing can take place. So the Bible says, you are the pillar and the foundation. And through that, truth reveals. Listen, we are God's hand of bringing the truth in the world. Oh, but I'm not good. Did I say you're good? Yeah, la, you are not good. True, I agree with you. But who is good? Jesus is good. Who is good? He is good. Are you good? No. Pastor Gurmeet, good? No. If I'm good, I won't be here today. I already enter into God's presence. If I'm too good, God take me home already. Finish. Job over. I still got things to work in my life. That's what God say. Stay for a while. Change your mind. Change your attitude. You know, sometimes you hear all these Mahaguru, Maharishi. Oh, you say, oh, they are so good. If they are so good, how come they still alive? I'm telling you that. If you are very good, you will absorb. Habis lah. Because the world cannot contain you. The world cannot contain you. So there are wrongs in our life that need to be corrected. Sometimes they are thoughts. Sometimes they are hurts. Sometimes they are brokenness, rejection. We have not let it go. Sometimes there are things in us. They're still struggling in us. That's where today you got to understand in your life, do not allow anything to hold you down. Let me tell you that. Because if you're not careful, what happened? You cannot become the pillar and the foundation. So it's very important for us to understand. And here, where did Hezekiah learn this? In the house of God. Where he learned this? In the house of God. He came to a place to understand, to serve the Lord, to give his life to the Lord, is a very essential thing to do. Serving the people, loving the people. Because when I come to the place to understand the concept of serving, I understand the concept of ministry. Some people come and say, oh, ministry is standing in this pulpit. Ministry is standing here. This is ministry. This is not ministry. Ministry is you're able to walk to someone and just lift up your hand up and say, hello, brother, how are you doing today? You fine? You okay? Family fine? Suddenly he start crying. What do? You just lay hand. This is ministry. Did I say anything? I just rub his shoulder on him. I just rub the shoulder on him. Is that ministry? That is ministering. You know what? I am pouring my love to him. I'm loving him. I'm listening to him. My eyes focus on him. I'm hearing him. My ears is given to him. My eyes is given to him. That's what ministry is. Many of us, we come to a point in life, we want to be ministered. Let me teach you today, why can't we just graduate from me being ministered? Now I learn to minister. Turn to your neighbor and say, you are a minister. You are a minister. Come on, mean it. Turn to your neighbor and say, you are a minister. You are an encourager. One day I was in an aeroplane flying, you know, the guy looked at me and asked me, what do you do? I'm a minister. The guy got shocked. Huh? Minister? What minister are you from? Which country are you from? From Malaysia. Wow, what ministry are you doing? Ministry of social. Helping the needy and the poor and the hungry and the broken. Wow, the guy got so excited. I never know I'm sitting with a minister. After half an hour and talk, I told him I'm a pastor. Then he kept quiet. After that, he doesn't want to talk anymore. My brother, we are called to serve the Lord. We are called to be involved in the house of God. And Hezekiah learned this. He learned this. He learned to obey. He learned to obey. For, do not turn to that. He learned the principle of serving the Lord. Serving the Lord. I want to serve. If David said what? David said what? What David said? It's better for me to be a doorkeeper in the house of God than to live in my palace. Have you ever wondered that? Doorkeeper. Of course, today there is no more temple. But we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Am I right? So we are together as one body, the house of God. We serve each other. Not only that person give me the water, I also give him the water. He must serve me. No, we serve each other. We help each other. We show love to each other. We come alongside each other. And to make sure that another becomes strong and propel the person to be closer to Jesus. That's why this is called pulpit. Pulpit. You know why? It's to pull somebody out of the pit. It is not called anything else. That's why it's called pulpit. Pull somebody out to the pit. Not to send the fella to the pit. This is not the place we send people to hell. This is the place we take them out of hell. This is the place we bring them redemption, grace, goodness, and love. So here was Hezekiah. He said, I want to serve the Lord. Not allow somebody else to do it. You know, some people got this thought in their mind, let them do it. It's okay. I'm already old. In the kingdom of God, there is no old. No old, I'm telling you. I pray that this body I have will be still strong enough to sustain. And I want to keep serving God even until the last day of my breath. My prayer to the Lord is, if you take me home right after my last preaching. After my last preaching, I sit down, I have my tea, then you can take me home, Lord. I'm ready. Don't take me home when I'm in a toilet. Don't take me home when I'm on my bed or whatever. Take me home right after I preach my last message. And I want to preach my last message because I never know when will the home come. My brother and my sister, Hezekiah, learned the principle of serving God. Number two, let's look at the scripture again. 2 Chronicles 31 verse 20, 21. Now, from the service of God's temple, all right, let's turn to in obedience of the law. In the obedience of the law. So what we learn next thing? We learn that Hezekiah took time. Listen, he is a king. He's a king. He could have get somebody else to do the job. But what did he do? In every work that he began, he took time to look in God's word. He took time to look into God's scripture. He is a king. He is not somebody who is seated on a lower ground. He is a man sitting in a high position. He can forget about the word of God and get into the business of the kingdom. Am I right? But no. The Bible says he took time to explore God's word. He took time to study God's word. He took time to read the scripture. I like just now what the brother was doing. He's reading scripture. Today in a church, nobody reads scripture anymore. That's the reason why we have weak Christians. That's the reason why we have Christians who are not committed to the faith, because there's no word of God read into their life. When I go to any hospital visitation, any counseling that I do, I only read scriptures. I only play scriptures. I only sing scriptures. You know why? Because the word of God will set the person free from every infirmity, every condition. If you are going through a most miserable time in your life, I suggest get scriptures, hear scriptures, let it come in your heart. You find God, transform your mind. And put faith in your life. This man knew because he saw the kingdom. In the Bible says Hezekiah was the best king Israel ever had in Judah. Judah had all the bad, a lot of bad king in Israel. And he's one of the very good one. He read scripture. Psalm 78 verse 1 say what? Give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ears to the word of my mouth. Now, there always a problem. Oh, we are living in grace. So why we are talking about law? I'll talk to you about that in third point. Give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ears to the word of my mouth. Isaiah 2:2 says, the law will go out of Zion, the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. This to show you the power of the word of God, how he strengthens you, how he regenerates you, how he edifies you, and how he builds you. The word of God, it's very powerful. You want to talk about marriage? If you have problem, look at what the Bible says. You want to talk about finance? You have a problem? Look what the Bible says about finance. You talk about investment? Look at what the Bible says about investment. Talk about buying things? Look at the scripture, what the Bible says about buying things. If you want to talk about eating, look at scripture, what the Bible says about eating. The best dietary program is also in the Bible. Look at the scripture, what the word of God says over your condition. And the word of God can give you clarity and change your life accordingly. My life is transformed not because I read books of other fellows' journey. I read the word, I heard the word, and I put it into my heart and allow the Holy Spirit to incubate that word. My fellow brothers and sisters, give your ears to God's word, because only the word of God will transform you and change you. And what the Bible says in 2 Timothy 3:16, all scripture is inspired by God and beneficial. What do you mean by inspired? Breathe. All scripture is breath of God. And he has benefit. For what? Teaching, rebuke, correction, training of righteousness. The word of God corrects your journey. Changes your thought pattern. Make you think before you talk. If you want to learn about how life should be, read book of Proverbs. It will turn your life upside down. I got my children all to read that. I told them this is your homework for whole month. Read book of Proverbs chapter 30. My fellow brothers and sisters, Paul instructed Timothy about this. So Paul is also telling this to us. Telling this to us. What Jesus said, the spirit give life, the flesh for nothing. The words I have spoken to you, they are full of spirit of life. Okay? The spirit give life. The flesh counts for nothing. But the word I have spoken to you, the word, the rhema word of God I have spoken to you. The word I have spoken to you, they are full of spirit and life. So what happened now? We are a powerhouse. You know powerhouse like TNB? When your house taman, no electricity, then TNB send a truck, am I right? And they park it there, and they put the power supply into your house and repair their own genset, and this power supply supply electricity to your house. So you are a portable power supply. Portable power bank. Hallelujah. Would you mind lift up your hand right now and say, thank you for making me a portable power bank. Portable power bank. You are a power supply of God. The word of God breathes in you. Therefore, you can release God's presence wherever you go. Portable power bank. Portable power bank. Brothers, sisters, I tell you, I just went and ministered to a brother who's dying of a cancer. And I just visited him in a hospital. And after praying for him, something told me the spirit man needs some jerk, some what we call jump start. Spirit man needs some jump start. So I walked to him and asked him, brother, he's not young, he's a very elderly man, condition not too good, but still God's hand is upon his life. I say, brother, have you received the baptism of the Holy Spirit? Do you speak in tongue? He looked at me, he said, no. There's one thing I never believe. I say, would you like to give God that opportunity to release that gift in your life? They look at me and said, okay. I say, let's pray. Right in the hospital, we lay hand, I lay hand, we pray. And from nowhere, he started to burst in tongues. Started to cry. Tears came down from his eyes. He couldn't believe. And he started to talk to us, not in English, in some foreign language. He's talking to us. He couldn't even talk in English. The Holy Spirit came and swept him. Suddenly he had what we call spiritual jumpstart. Something happened in his system. And when I visited him a few days ago, he's excited. He had glow on his face. He said, I am going through, by right, I supposed to be going through pain. By right, I supposed to be on a morphine. By right, this is what I should be going through. But, Pastor, I am not in any painkiller. I'm not in any morphine. When I heard that, I said, this must be God's word. The Holy Spirit came in, make him to become a powerhouse again. Because the spirit man came back to life. You know, your spirit man here cannot do anything without God's word. Your spirit man needs God's word. The breath of God through the word bring a resurrection of life. Oh, he took time to read God's word. Do not despise. You come and tell me, Pastor, I don't understand all this. What is beget, 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 beget? You read book of Matthew, Luke. Beget this, beget this, beget this. I don't understand. In China, those days, they got no Bible. So when they get Bible in China, they will tear the pages and give the pages to every Chinese man, every Chinese family. And what they do is, they take the pages and they write it down. Do you know that? They will write down those, you know, you can go to China and see Bible written by human hand. They will write down the whole one chapter front and back. They will write down in a piece of paper to keep it there. And one of the Chinese men got the chapter called Bigit, Bigit, Bigit. You know, this Bigit. And after the whole thing, he finished right. He felt so blessed when the pastor came to collect his page and give him another page. He said, I'm so blessed. If God can remember the forefathers of these people, I'm sure God remember my forefathers. Look at how he saw it. I'm sure God have a record of my father, forefathers. And I'm sure God have a record of their life too. I'm blessed to read Bigit story. For you mean nothing, but for the Chinaman who in the field planting that small page of Bigit, gave him a revelation. God remembers my generation. Because for Chinese, generation very important. God remember my generation. And that made his faith to become stronger. Hallelujah. Word of God. Then, let's look at 2 Chronicles 31 again. Same verse, but now we go to the commands. This is very important. Because many of them got a problem with this. The commands. In every work that he began, in the commandment, respect to live godly right before God. In everything that we do, there is a commandment, there is an instruction you must follow. If you do not follow this instruction, you cannot prosper. Now, this is where the problem of grace and law come in. Some people come and tell me, Pastor, I'm saved by grace, no more law. So now grace has come in my life, therefore, I no need to have law anymore. I look at the fuller, is it? This is the problem we have, careless, clueless Christians in the world. Where did Jesus say, I came to abolish law? What did Jesus say? I came to fulfill the law. Then what did Jesus say? I'm giving you my spirit to teach you all truth. And the truth is not just New Testament. You understand? To teach you all truth means from the old covenant to the new covenant. Therefore, you must understand there is certain condition you must follow. And what is the condition you must follow? For grace. Listen carefully. Read the scripture properly. For the grace of God has appeared that offers salvation to all people. What the grace of God did? He gave you salvation. Am I right? It teaches to say no to ungodliness. What does grace do? No to ungodliness. No to worldly passion. To live a self-controlled life, upright and godly in the present age. Now. So those who are preaching grace must also preach this scripture. So you must understand, you have grace, you got to say no to ungodliness. Some people say, oh, I'm a Christian, I can do whatever I want. I can minum mabo until I become drunk and God will forgive me. I come to church, I give my offering, I give my tithe, soft. No, you are killing yourself. You are lying to yourself. You're going to destroy your life and you're going to get yourself miserable. Don't play fool with the devil. He is not a stupid fella. Some people think the devil is an idiot. Nah, he's far smarter than any one of you all. You can never outbeat him, because if you can outbeat him, he wouldn't be making all the mess today. The only person who can beat the devil down is the Lord Jesus himself. You can shout and scream, where is Satan? Under my feet. Where is Satan? Under my feet. My foot is under your feet. If Jesus is not in your life. Very nice, huh? Where is the devil? Under my feet. Yeah, but do you have Jesus constantly living in your life? My fellow brothers and sisters, many people don't like my messages, so they will give an angry symbol on Facebook. Very upset. But I care nothing, lah, because I don't know what's going to happen tomorrow to me. He said, no to ungodliness. Yes, grace given to you as salvation, correct. But you must say no to ungodliness, to worldly passion. Live your life as self-control. That means, must have control, lah. Am I stopping you to take alcohol? You want to take? I can't stop you because it's your body. But you must have self-control. Because alcohol is same as greedy, gluttony. Same. Drinking too much coffee, taking too much Coca-Cola. Same lah. Just that one is taking alcohol, which is beer, a higher level of alcohol. But you're also taking coffee, which is also bad. 20 cup, 30 cup a day, also bad. Smoking also bad. Everything that you do beyond is bad. Even sleeping and oversleeping is bad. You understand? Whatever you do beyond the norm is bad. So I'm not just talking about alcohol, I'm talking about everything. You must have self-control. You must know when to stop. You must know when to stop. And the Bible says, if you got this, you got to live an upright and godly life. What Jesus said? Matthew 22, verse 36 and 40. Teach, teacher, which is the greatest commandment in the law? What Jesus said? Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. That is the first greatest commandment. And second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. All the law and the prophet hung on these two commandments. You know what I mean? It's a very powerful text, you know. That means the law is the teaching of the Moses, the Ten Commandments. That's law. Prophet is the teaching of the prophets in the Bible. These two hang on these two law. What is it? Love God. Number two, love your neighbor. Who is your neighbor? Ah, that's very interesting. He's not talking about a neighbor in the home. Who is your neighbor? The one sitting beside you is your neighbor, lah. Nah, the one sitting at the back of you, brother, is your neighbor. Who is your neighbor? Do you love the one sitting beside you? Do you pray for them? Do you care? Would you die for them? That is very bad. Jesus laid his life down for us. Let me tell you this. The days will come that the test will be upon us to see whether we are faithful to our call. Who is your neighbor? The one who's sitting left and right. Did you greet your neighbor today who's left and right? Did you say hello to them? Maybe now should do it. Come on. Okay, go ahead. Let's do it. Say hello to your neighbor. Welcome. Thank you very much for joining us today for service. Come on, go. There's some people sitting. There's one lady sitting there, sister, the Indian sister sitting there. Come on, go and greet them. Welcome them to the house of God. Come on, go. Say hello. Good to see you. Nice to have you here. God bless you. There's your neighbor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bakamasibi kuriandoro bakatala. In the name of Jesus. Oh, bless you, bless you, bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Isn't it wonderful? That is your neighbor. Knowing your neighbor, very important. So next Sunday, when you sit in the church, you find the city in the left and right is empty. You take a phone and call the person. Hey, I feel so lonely this Sunday. Why, huh? Because the seat where you sit, you're not there. Yeah. What happened to the person? What happened to the person? What happened? He become happy. Somebody know I miss the church. Somebody saw me. Somebody cared for me. Somebody loved me. Somebody walked with me. My friends, church is not difficult. Church is very easy. If you can learn to love your neighbor, you can build a powerful house. You can build a powerful house. You can build a powerful house. Church is very powerful if you understand this principle of loving your neighbor. Not gossiping about the neighbor. You know, when Jesus came, he washed the disciples' feet. Am I right? Then Peter became very concerned. What he said, Jesus, don't wash my feet. My whole body is so dirty. Then what did Jesus say? No. Only dirty right now is your feet. So I clean your feet because that is dirty. You understand? So I only clean what is dirty right now. So my job is to protect you so that you will be clean in the area. So what is the whole washing of the feet is about? It's about protecting someone and cleaning up for the person and loving the person so that individual can receive his or her breakthrough. There are a lot of people in church who need somebody to wash their feet, who need somebody to take care of their mind, how they think. That's how you learn. Because you cannot have the commandment in the old and the prophet, the law and the prophet to be functioned without you love God, without you love your neighbor. This commandment means nothing. But this commandment means all if you learn to love God and love those who come on your way. Jesus said, if you love me, keep my, got grace, huh? Got law or not here? This law or grace? If you love me, keep my. But you are Christian now. Why you worry? You're Christian now, man. Nothing to be worried, eh? Correct? But as a Christian, you must learn to love God. And that is a commandment. That is not grace. That is a law. You need to learn to love him. That's why we come to church. We got our core values. We got 10 commandments. 10 commandments still function to today. It still have not gone broken. 10 commandments still stay today. Love your father and your mother. Your life will be long. That is a commandment. I close here. I have 2 more points. Never mind. Let the church call me again. I have a mother came to the church. Tell me, you can do anything with my daughter, Pastor Gurmeet. I can do anything with your daughter. No. You can do anything to my daughter, Pastor Gurmeet, but don't baptize her in water. Chinese have this belief. You will go to church, you go to church, but don't get baptized in water. So I say, why, auntie? Why are you so worried? Oh, if she get baptized in water, then if I die, she will forget me. I said, okay. So I kept quiet for a while. Then she looked at me, she asked me, why are you so quiet? I said, auntie, I'll make sure she get baptized in water and she will love you until you can never die. Is he okay or not? Is he okay or not? She looked at me, yeah. I get her baptized in water. She will love Jesus. And she will love you so much until you pay tahan. She kept quiet. He said, what are you saying? I said, that is a Christian faith. That is a Christian faith. Because the Bible says, love your father and your mother so your life will be long. It's a Christian faith. For us to have a long life, we must love you, auntie. We must care for you, auntie. Where you got the idea that when a person get baptized in the water, he will forget you? Where you got the idea? Who told you that? Oh, I heard this from someone. I heard this from someone. I tell you, this is from the Word. You know what happened that day? She became a Christian. Mother, daughter got baptized. This wrong teaching of Christian faith. We are not here to discard and to throw away our family members and our loved ones. We must love them, provide what we can provide, walk with them. We cannot give all our bank money. Yes, I know. But if you can, God bless you. But you can't, it's okay, but you can provide food, am I right? You can buy food and give them food today. Very easy. Someone called me, Pastor, got no food. Huh? I say, no problem. I send Grab food to your house. Does this, I got to drive. Ooh, nowadays, no more. Just call my friend from the restaurant. He will send the food straight. Job done. I stop here. I cannot go anymore. Are you following God's commandment? That's why Hezekiah prospered. That's why he prospered. That's why he went on growing. And that is the reason why he became a man after God. Became a servant of God, in a great testimony of his life stands out the most. Amen. Can I get the musician to come? Where are you today? Where are you today? Let's look at the scripture in our closing once again. Once again, all right? But I will not get this topic. Just look at the scripture. This is what Hezekiah did throughout Judah. Doing what was good and right and faithful before the Lord God in everything that he undertook, the service of God's temple and obedience to the law. I'm supposed to speak about this now, but we will talk this next time. And walk wholeheartedly as he prospered. So let's read from the backward. How did he prosper? He worked wholeheartedly. He sought God. He followed the commandment. He obeyed the law of God. Sorry, he followed the commandment. He obeyed the word of God. He served God. And then he was faithful. And he did what is good and what is right. That's why he prospered. Hallelujah. So Chinese brothers, sisters, you want to be fat, 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 fat? Huh? You want to see all kind of ong, 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 ong? Your spiritual life also must be ong. Understand? Because when your spiritual life is ong, then your physical life also ong. One of the biggest problems in the medical world today is your spiritual life. If your spiritual life is totally blocked up, then you find sickness come into your body. High blood pressure, sugar, diabetic. When you don't have sleep, you're troubled from sleeping, insomnia, and all kind of sickness, disease walk in your life. Because your spirit man is not strong. Huh? And that makes you become weaker and weaker. So when you go to hospital, you spend more money on the medicine. But now I teach you to spend lesser money in medicine and get your spirit man stronger again. You need to become spiritually rich. May God make you prosperous spiritually. Amen. Would you mind standing up to your feet as we worship God? Thank you, Lord Jesus. How about this? Come on, let's just open up your mouth wherever you are. Come on, give thanks to God for a moment. Just getting the right song.
Thank you, Lord. Can we all lift our hands to the Lord?
Yes. Hallelujah. Go ahead.
Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, Lord. Come on, open up your heart for a while. Lift up your hand. Up
Lord, there. I give you my heart.
Thank you, Jesus.
Give you my soul, I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I wake, Lord, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul. I live for you alone.
Come on.
Every breath that I take.
Yes, Jesus.
Every moment I wait.
Shiba karabas shibi kuriandarai.
Lord, have your way. Lord, I give. Lord, I give you my heart.
Oh, we bless you, Jesus.
I give you my soul.
Oh, we bless your name. We bless your name.
I live for you.
Shiba karabas shibi
kuriandarai. Every breath that I take. Every moment I'm away, Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way in me.
Come on, lift up your voice up with this song once again.
This is my desire.
Come on, open up your heart to honor you.
To honor you.
Yes, Jesus, we praise your name, we praise your name, we praise your name.
Lord, with all my heart, I worship you.
We bless your name, Lord Jesus.
Ooh.
We give you glory and honor.
And all that within me,
I give you praise.
I give you praise. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take,
every moment
I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me.
Just a voice. Lord, I give you my heart.
Lord, I give you my heart. My soul.
Let it be a prayer.
I live for you alone.
Yes, Jesus.
Every breath that I take.
Every moment.
Every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me.
Once again.
Lord, I give you my heart.
Yes, Jesus.
I give you my soul. I live for you alone.
Every breath
that I take. Every moment I'm awake.
Yes, Jesus.
Lord, have your way in me.
Hallelujah.
Lord, have your way. Lord, have your
way in me. Just close your eyes, lift up your head up. Let the Holy Spirit come and touch some of your heart. Lord Jesus, where you stand is your altar, right? I can open the altar, but I believe there's another service after this. I want you to come back for that service to worship God for a while. But where you stand right now, that is your altar. That's a place of prayer. Just lift your hand up. Don't put your head down. Lift your head up. Say, Lord Jesus, I am your vessels. I belong to you. Listen, he loves you so much. I'm telling you, Jesus loves you so very much. Oh, he does not love you, he adores you. He longs to hear your voice. He longs to touch the depth of your heart. He longs to set you free that you can walk in victorious life. He wants to prosper you.
but he wants to prosper you spiritually first. Lord Jesus, let your power come upon my brothers, my sisters, wherever they stand. Let them get themselves right before you, Lord. Because just a touch from you is far greater than touch from any man or any woman can give. Touch my sister. Touch my brother. Let the fire of God come upon them in Jesus' name. Pour upon them, O God. Marabas Sibiriandara, if you can speak in the language of the Holy Spirit, I just want to speak. Sibiriandara Kasitiriandara. Naku Sibiriamo Koturiandara. He Karabas Sibiriandara Baka. Naraba Kuriandara Baka Talayandara. Hey, Karaba Shibiriandro Boko Turiandro Bakatala. In Naraba Shibikuriandro Boko Rianda. Zibiriandro Boko Turiandro Yanda. Hey, Riandro Yandro Bakatala. Shibiriamor Yandro Yandro Bakuriande. Hey, Riandro Bakuriamorondro Bakuriandra. Rebarabaraba Shibiriamorondro Yandro Bakuriandra. Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. Jesus. I live for you alone. Every breath. Every breath that I take. Every moment. Every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart, give you my soul. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Just be peace in God's presence. Don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. Just stand where you are. Close your eyes. He is here in the midst of us to touch, to heal, to restore. Lama Kositi. I will strengthen you, says the Lord. I will build you, says the Lord. I will inspire you, says the Lord. I will mold you, says the Lord. It is me will pour my breath of life upon you, says the Lord. My spirit will guide you, says the Lord. For I will lift you up from your dry and muddy condition, says the Lord. I will lift you up. I will lift you up, says the Lord. Not man. I will lift you up, says the Lord. I will build you and strengthen you according to my fashion. I will place to you my destiny. I will place to you my future. I will place to you my voice. That you will be my voice in the midst of darkness. You will be the light. You will shine and you will declare my goodness, says the Lord. For I am your Father, I am your Master, I am your Savior, says the Lord. Now I will give you the strength that you never had. And I will give you the wisdom that you never had. I'll give you the insight that you never had. Just wait in my presence, says the Lord. Seek my face. Serve me. Pour your life on me. For I will use you to be my instrument of blessing, says the Lord. I will use your hand. I will use your mouth. I will use your eyes. I will use your ears. That you may be able to see and hear and touch lives. And transform hearts. And sing my hope reign over them. For I am your God. For I am your King, says the Lord. Receive my touch, says Jesus. Touch them, O God. Pour upon them. In Jesus' name. Let's sing this song once again. This is my desire.
This is my desire.
Give you praise.
I give you praise, Lord. Adore is in you. Let's sing together, Lord. I give you my heart, Lord. I give you my heart. I give you my soul.
A clap offering. Yeah, very important. Today's topic is spiritual prosperity. So you will not have physical prosperity without spiritual prosperity. Yes, some of you may have physical prosperity. The devil will come and steal, kill, and destroy if you do not have spiritual authority, spiritual prosperity. Brother and sister, God bless all of us. Go with the shalom of God. Go with the peace of God. Come back next Sunday at the same time, at the same place. Do you, if you really need some urgent prayer, I Pastor Gomisen will pray for you. Otherwise, God bless all of us. Remember, afternoon we have worship encounter service. It's organized by worship team, correct? Worship team, only, don't too long, only 1 hour. 1 hour solid worship, no word, just worship. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless all of us. Amen. Hallelujah.